Right, greetings class. Today we are going to work on all the calculations za unogona kuwana dziri mu combined science. All the calculations. Saka tichatanga nema calculations anowanika ku biology section. Ma calculations anowanika ku biology section ma calculations anenge achitaura pamusoro pe inonzi germination. Achitaura pamusoro pe inonzi germination. So by definition, germination, it is the development of a seed into a new plant. Development of a seed into a new plant. Okay? Kana seed rika developer kusika rava plant, we call that germination. And we have the conditions necessary for germination to take place. We have a suitable temperature, which is important for activating the enzymes. We have what you call oxygen, which is important for the process of respiration. And the process of respiration is also important for providing energy that will help the seed to germinate. We also have another condition called moisture, which is important for metabolism reactions or for chemical reactions to take place. Now I have the question. Yandina ipana. Iri kutaura kuti a farmer planted 125 seeds, which means the seeds planted. They were what? 125. So a farmer planted 125 seeds. And only 105 seeds germinated. Kura kuti pama seeds planted tatine 125 and seeds germinated. We have 105. So a farmer planted 125 seeds, but only 105 seeds germinated. Then the question, it says, calculate percentage germination. Percentage germination. So percentage germination, they wanna say, notions of this formula and you know T. Number of seeds germinated, okay? In other words, I'm saying for you to get percentage germination, you say the seeds germinated all over total number of seeds planted. This is one of the series that is going to help you before you enter into your final examination at this year. So you better listen as I am explaining these calculations. I will not touch only on calculations, but I will also touch on other areas. But our focus for now, we are talking about calculations. So if you want to calculate the number of seeds germinated, you say, if you want to calculate the percentage of seeds germinated, you say seeds germinated all over total number of seeds planted times 100, because we are talking about percentage. So we are going to say what? We are going to have number of seeds germinated, it's 105 all over 125 times 100. And if you do your calculations very well, you are going to see that if we say by 25, you're going to have 6. It's 5 here. Sorry, it's 5. Then by 25, we're going to have 4. Then 5 into this one, we're going to give 21. 21 times 4, we are going to have 84%. Which means the percentage germination was 84%. What if they say, calculate the percentage that did not germinate? if they say the percentage that did not germinate, unenge uchiti number of seeds that did not germinate or over total number of seeds planted times 100, then you get the percentage. Okay, so this is one, this is the most important calculation that you're going to actually come across kana wakuno answer biology section. So on biology section, you are going to answer this question. Panoya ma calculations. Do ma calculations anoya in the biology section. So atidi kunya kutaura zvakawandisa. Now takuenda pa ma calculations anobvunzwa ku physics question.
Mm-hmm. So okay, kana takuda kuona the seeds that did not germinate, mm-hmm. T 105 minus 125.
No, we say 125 minus 105.
125 minus 105. And
then you get what?
20.
Then it's
20 over 125.
So the number of seeds that did not
germinate.
Remember, you're looking for the percentage that did not germinate. Okay, mm-hmm. So you're going to say total number of seeds planted 125 minus number of seeds germinated 105, right? All over the total number of seeds planted, it's 125, then times 100, because you're looking for the percentage. So you're going to have 20 over 125 times 100. Okay, so by 25 we obtained 5 here, by 25 we obtained 4, then 5 into this one is what? It's 4. Then 4 times 4 we get 16%. As you can see, this 16% and this 84%, they add up to 100%. So that's a very, very good question. A very, very good question. So now we want to look at the calculations that might come in physics section. Okay? And in physics, here in November 2018, vakatipa pie chart here, Fig 6.2 is a pie chart showing people using a particular source of energy. So I just saw solar as a source of energy. It's they were represented by 36 degrees. Like Shandisa oil as a source of energy, they were represented by 90 degrees. Like Shandisa water as a source of energy, they were represented by 108. Like Shandisa coal as the source of energy, 72%. And like Shandisa natural gas as a source of energy, panga pasina degree, but it's easy for you to get the degree. Unori wana say degree racho. Unengo wakungoti 36 plus 90 plus 108 plus 72, then about from chi 360. Because a complete circle, it add up to 360. So for natural gas, these are calculations. Natural gas, we are going to say 360. Minus, if we add the total, we are going to get we are going to get, it's actually 36 plus 90 plus 108 plus 72. So on a 306, so you're going to say minus 306, then you're going to obtain what if you say 360 minus 306. So unenge wakuwana 54, you're going to get 54 degrees, which means natural gas was represented by 54 degrees. These are just calculations. In case they can just say find the degree represented by natural what? By natural gas. But what is the question saying? Hence, identify the energy source which is mostly widely used. It was water, both in a greatest degree. Anditika, saka it's water. That's why they take water is the correct answer. Right, next question says, calculate the percentage of the people using natural gas. So the percentage of the people using natural gas, tinenge tichiti chi, tinenge tichiti isisi the degree represented by natural gas is what 54 both tari chaka kudara. It's 54 all over the total degrees. It's what 360. Then times 100. Why? Because we are looking for the percentage. Percentage, it means 100. Not to put these things here. You don't have to put those percentage because it's 54 degrees, not percent. Okay? Then you do your calculations. This zero and this zero, they cancel each other. And we have by 2, we get 18. By 2, we get 5. Then by 2, get 9. By 2, get 27. 9 into 27, and 2 pindaka 3. So it will be 3 here times 5. Then we obtain 15%, which means the percentage for natural gas was 15%. Same applies if they ask about the percentage represented by water. We say the degree represented by water, which is 108 all over the degree, the total degree, which is 360 times 100. Same applies if they say the percentage represented by oil. We say the degree representing oil all over the total degrees times 100. You get it? So this is the first calculation in physics that you need to know. Usatu watombopinda mu exam. Mango ma calculations about this area awanogona kubvunza. Ndiye kuti. Let me just erase everything here. I want you to listen as I am going to give this question because I'm just formulating it here so that you can understand some of the questions that might come in this same area. All right, so they can say if the number of people using solar energy were 60. Are you listening? If the number of people using solar energy were 60, how many people were using water? You see? So ivo vari kuti ivo, solar energy is represented by 36 degrees. What they are trying to say is this 30 degrees on this pie chart is representing how many people? 60 people. And they are saying if the number of people using solar energy were 60, how many number of people using water as a source of energy? So in other words, they are saying if 36 degrees is representing 60 people, what about the degree of water? What about 108 is representing what? X. Are you following this? Right, then you apply cross multiplications. I told you, okay, it's the same as 36 all over 108 equal to 60 over what? Over x is the same as this one. You see, is the same. Unongo sa division up kanongo ita cross multiplication is the same, right? Saka patikata cross multiplication, we are going to get 36x equivalent to 60 times 108, then both side by 36, both side by 36. So our x, number of people using water as a source of energy, they were what at cut by 6 to 6, right? Ticket by 6 to 10, ticket by 2 to 3, by 2 to 5. Then 3 into this one, anopindaka 3. Saka pata 5 ka. 3 asia remenda 1. Into 18 is 6. Andetika. Saka ta asara na 5 times 36. Inengerichi 5, 36. 30, carry 3, 15, 18, 108. Saka vanu, water is the source of energy. There were 180 people. You need to understand this. Okay, let us look at another calculation that you need to know. Right. This question, it says, a box contains resistors of different sizes. 10 resistors. 10 resistors are rated 5 ohms. Correct. 10 resistors, each resistor per 10, they were rated 5 ohms. Then 12 resistors are rated 8 ohms. And 8 resistors are rated 10. And 10 resistors are rated 15. You get it?
Mm-hmm.
Right. Saka tine total resistor, mama resistor tina total mangani. Saka tine 10 plus G.
8.
Plus 12. It's 10 plus 12. Right? Plus G. 8.
Mm-hmm.
Plus G.
10.
Do total number ma resistor tina.
Mm-hmm.
State any way. In one way of presenting the data apart from the description, ndogo na represent on a table. This is ndogo na represent on a bar chart. Ndogo na represent on a pie chart. But isusu paninye eda, basa kutu ndogo na represent where. Our focus is on calculations. Calculate the percentage of resistors rated 15. So the resistor rated 15. How many resistors rated 15? There were 10. So we are saying the total number of resistors rated what? 15. They were what? They were 10. All over. The total number of resistors, we're going to say 10 plus 12 plus 8 plus 10. So 10 plus 10, you're going to have 20. Plus 12 plus 8 is plus what? 20 again. So total number of resistors, they were 40. Since they are saying the percentage, you're going to say times 100. Then we cancel this 0 and this 0. By 2, we get 2. By 2, get 5. Right?
Mm-hmm.
2 into this one, it's 5. 5 times 5, we get what? 25%. Same applies if they say the resistor represented by the percentage of resistors represented by let me just say 8 ohm. You know, the total number of resistors with 8 ohms rated 8 ohms,
mm-hmm.
which is 12, over total number of resistors 40
times
100. 100, then you get your answer. That's it. Right, ndoinda pane another calculation iri panapa yakati Fig 14.1 shows how the length of a glass rod was measured.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Name the instrument used to measure length of a glass rod. That instrument is called vernier calipers. On vernier calipers, vernier calipers, it is used to measure the internal diameter of a pipe. Right? But you need to understand the readings. How do you read vernier calipers? Right?
Mm-hmm.
Then here you can study the length of the glass rod. Yakato measure yakato buda. So let us say we read here tine 1, 1, 2, 3. Saka tina 1, 3. Balasa tapenza. Because apenza that yakashika neche pakati. But it's hard to go nuti kana yakashika neche pakati pana pata kuti saka ye 3, 1, 3, 5. No. Tinofana kurida. Taku chifu muva manje tichichaka kuti pakanangana chibaje kumusoro kune chekuzasi nde papi. Saka takuti from 3 apa takuti 1 2 3 4 5 apa ndopane zvibaje akaita sei zvakanangana zvekutanga. Saka kuri kuti it's 1,3. Then 1 2 3 4 5. 1,3 5 millimeter centimeters, about centimeters here. Yeah? Right. Then to end up on another calculation, they are saying one side of a cube measures 6 centimeters.
6,0 centimeters.
Calculate the volume of the cube. Volume of the cube. Volume of the cube. So for us to get the volume of a cube, we say length times width times height, which is going to be 6 times 6 times 6. And you are going to obtain 216 cubic centimeters. That's volume. Right, next question that we have, it says, a force of 300 Newton pulls an object of mass 60 kg along a horizontal surface. Right? So let's calculate the acceleration of the object. What is the acceleration? Acceleration, by definition, it is change in the speed. Of course, it's talking about the positive change, like as it increases, but it is just change in the speed, known as acceleration. So for us to get acceleration, we say force over mass. Force over mass. And we you can walk when you force in Newton over what? Mass. In what? In kg, kilograms. Mm. So our force in Newton is what? 300. Mm. So again, say 300. Right? O over 60. Then you are going to obtain what? 5 meters per square second. Because our acceleration, it is measured in meters per square what? Second. Right, and the next question that we have, it says, a ball of mass 0.4 kg, it accelerates uniformly. And the word uniformly here, it means without breaking, at 2 meters per square second. Pavango t per square second, which means this one, that was the acceleration. So this one in kg was the mass. Then they are saying, calculate the force of the ball. By definition, force, it is a push or a pull. So force, it is calculated by saying mass times acceleration. And what is our mass? It must be something, that number in kilograms or in kg, which is 0.4 times acceleration, which is in meters per square second, which is 2, then you are going to get 0.8 Newton, because the force is measured in Newton. Okay. Here is another question on calculations. Hans, a boy pushes a wheelbarrow with a force of 25 Newton against a frictional force of 7 Newton. By definition, friction, it means the force that opposes motion. And the word motion, it means movement. So any force that opposes movement, it is called friction. The question that we are going to focus on is on calculation. Calculate the resultant force on the wheel. How do we calculate resultant force? Always resultant force, it is equal to the force applied. Force applied minus frictional force. So the force applied, it was 25 Newton minus frictional force, 7 Newton. So the force applied was 25 Newton and it was being opposed by 7 Newton, which was called frictional force. So the resultant force, we are referring to the force that was acting. Because you applied 25 Newton, but you are going to see that from 25 Newton that you have applied, 7 Newton is being opposed by frictional force. So the force that is going to work is not 25, but the force that is going to work, it's 25 minus 7, which is what? 18 Newton. That one, we call it resultant force. You get it? Let us find another calculation. Now on this question, a 400 kg car is moving with a constant velocity, speed. Velocity, it means speed. And speed or velocity is measured in meters per second. So 400 kg car is moving with a constant. Constant, it means stationary, which means is moving, maintaining a speed of 100 meters per second. That's why they are saying a 400 kg car is moving with a constant speed of 100 meters per second, which means it's moving, maintaining this speed in 100 meters per second. The first question, of course, is not of calculations. Define velocity. Velocity, it means rate of change of displacement. It means rate of change of what? Displacement. Now on our calculations, which is our main subject of this series. Calculate the momentum of the car. Momentum of the car. Momentum. Tineiwana kanatati mass times velocity. Mass times velocity. So our mass is 400 times the velocity. This one. So we're going to get 40,000 kg per second. And also, you need to know that by definition, momentum, it is mass in motion. Mass in motion. That's why you see even calculation actually, you say mass times velocity. So we want the mass while the object is moving. So again, say mass times velocity. Or you can define momentum as a product of mass and velocity, which means a product, you are saying a new thing formed when mass and velocity, they are multiplied. So it is a product of mass and velocity, or it is just mass in motion. You choose any definition that you want there. Why am I defining these terms? Because if they don't ask you about the calculation, they are going to ask you to define. We also have another terms like inertia in this area, like inertia. What is inertia? It is the object's natural tendency to resist change in its state of motion. Chinu chino tikana ndichifamba, ability yacho yeku resist change, ability of a thing to resist change in its state of motion, ndiyo inonzi inertia. Chinu kachifamba choramba chiti ndofamba ne speed yangu andichinjwe. That ability to resist any change, any force in its state of motion, we know the inertia. Now on mechanical systems, what we have here is a pulley system used to lift a load. So this is always a load, and this one is always effort. And these rings, these are pulleys, and tumatambot ropes, right? Let's go. State the velocity ratio of the pulley system. Please take note of this. Velocity ratio of any pulley system, just count number of pulleys, count number of pulleys. So tongo count ama pulley mangani 1 to 2. So the velocity ratio is what? It's 2. That's why this one is the correct answer. Then if they say calculate the mechanical advantage of the pulley system, mechanical advantage, it is found by saying load over effort. Load over effort. Load over effort. And what is our load here? Our load here is 160. is 160. All over effort, it's 80. Then we cancel this one and this one. 8 into this one, we're going to obtain 2. So our mechanical advantage is 2. And remember, mechanical advantage does not have any unit. Aina ma units, unungosia ngori 2, anza chingori 2. Next question says, calculate the efficiency of the pulley system.
Mm-hmm.
Efficiency, by definition,
mm-hmm.
it is the measure of how well a machine works. So for me to get efficiency, I use this formula, mechanical advantage over velocity ratio times 100. Then by that, I am going to get efficiency. I'm going to get the measure of how well the machine works.
Mm-hmm.
So the mechanical advantage is already there, which is 2 over
the velocity ratio is
2 times 100. So we are going to get 100% efficient, of which this is almost impossible.
Mm-hmm.
There is no there is no machine that is 100% efficient.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know how they set this exam. Yakatobuda 100. So shocking. Right, so there is no machine that is 100% efficient. Why? Inyaye friction. It's because of weight of the machine.
Mm-hmm.
You see? Mm-hmm. So those are the reasons. Friction of the moving parts, weight of the machine. It will result in any machine being not 100%. You get it? Right? So you're going to see them asking the question after getting the 100%. Right. Give any one reason why efficiency of the pulley is not 100%. Number one, it is because of friction of the moving parts, which is the force that opposes motion. In any machine, there is a force that opposes movement, motion. So because of that, any machine will never be 100%. What you are saying is that machine by definition, right?
Mm-hmm.
It is a device used to make work easier to do. So any device, think of any device that can make work easier to do. That device, you need to do something, be it mental labor, but you're going to apply. That's why you're saying it will never be 100% efficient, because if it becomes 100% efficient, it means it works on its own. It switches on its own. It also switches off on its own. But if I go and switch off and switch on, it means its work, its efficiency, its measure of how well it works, it is not going to be 100%, because I put some effort there of switching on and switching off. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And also another reason is why the efficiency of a machine is not 100% is because of the weight of a machine.
Mm-hmm.
I always talked about the example of a wheelbarrow. Those wheelbarrows that are very heavy, right? Anything, weight of a machine. So how do we correct this? How do we improve efficiency of a machine? We can only improve, not to make efficiency of a machine 100%, because it will never happen, right? So how do we improve? We are going to lubricate the friction up. Lubrication.
Mm-hmm.
We are also going to build machines using lighter materials. If the weight of a machine is affecting us, let us just build what? Machines with lighter material. Or we can just say reduce weight of a machine. All right, state and other examples of machines: inclined plane, lever, gears, wheels, and other things there. Right, now on this block, Fig 15.1 shows a concrete block of the mass resting on its biggest face. 0.5 meters, 2 meters, 1 meter. Calculate the pressure exerted by the block. By definition, pressure It is force acting per unit area.
Mm-hmm.
And its formula for calculating force mm-hmm. is force, pressure is equal to what? Force over area. Area. And that area, it must be in square meters. So let us do this. For me to get force, the information that is given here, I have to... So this question, I saw that there is information that is missing. That is missing. So let us just skip it. Right. Now on inclined plane, shows an inclined plane, calculate the mechanical advantage, MA, of the inclined plane. So mechanical advantage, I change a formula. It's just load over effort. Load yedu is this one, which is 40 over effort that is being applied. In arrow is 10. So it's load over effort. Then you are going to get 4. Mechanical advantage, it's load over effort, which is this one. And then you can calculate the velocity ratio, VR, of the inclined plane. Right, velocity ratio, and that is the distance moved by effort, or over distance moved by chi, by load. Saka, how do you know what to end the distance moved by effort? This is the effort applied, 10 newton, and end all load ya chere push way. But load ya famba kubva panapa kusika up. Saka tete chiti Jesus, tete chiti distance moved by effort, ndoe kubaba kudai, I effort kaya ichingo pusha chingo kushika yashika up. Saka distance zio, it's 6 meters. All over distance moved by load kubaba kuinda up, which is 3 meters, and you're going to get velocity ratio, iri 2. Okay? Right, to end up, panemangu my questions. Right, this question, it says, I feel like you need to know this answer. State any one factor that results in more energy losses in machines. Why the efficiency of the machine is not 100%? It's because of friction of the moving parts. Right, state the formula of calculating pressure in liquids. It's pressure minus, is equal to PGH. We're going to talk about it. Kumberu. Alright. Here, calculate the pressure exerted on 1.5 meter column of water, given that its density is 1200 kg per square meter. Acceleration due to gravity is 10 meters per square second. Alright. So pressure is that is equal to PGH. And our P here, this one, it represents density. This P, it, so we are saying it's density, which is 1200 times. Then this one, G here, it's gravity. Gravity, which is given 10. And did you go? Then to put times, because PGH, P times G times H. Then this H here, it represented the height. So pressure, it is equal to density, P, times gravity, G, times H, height. Sakatango substitute, you are going to get 18,000 pascals, because pressure, it is measured in pascals. So if you multiply density, is this one 1200 times gravity is 10, is given, times height it's 1.5, then again to get 18,000 pascals. Then again, this is a weird problem. A man drags 60 kg bag up the inclined plane of length 4.5 meters and height of 1.5. Sandongo draws very good. Very good. Papan inclined plane, something like this. Right, this is what they are saying. Dova assumes the 60 60 kg load, right? Ndova zvaita sei? Ndova afamba a length of 4.5 meters kubva apa kuenda panzi, it's 4.5. Ndobanzi and the height of 1.5 is the height kubva apa kusvika apa. Right? To load it into the lorry, calculate the velocity ratio of the inclined plane. Ndambokuudzai pamashure apo kuti velocity ratio of an inclined plane tinenge tichiti isusu a distance moved by load over distance a distance moved by effort over distance moved by load, but in this case it is the length of the incline forever this one 4.5 or over height of the incline which is 1.5, then we are going to obtain this one as the correct answer. Right, let's go on to my gears now. Right, a gear system has 10 teeth in the driving gear. Rinonzi the driving gear anditi. This one called the driving gear. This one is the smaller gear. Right? This is the smaller gear. And 30 teeth in the driven gear. The driven gear is the larger gear. Right, then item one it says calculate the velocity ratio of the gear system. Please understand me kuti tiwane the velocity ratio of the gear tinenge tichiti isus number of teeth in the driven gear which is larger gear. Number of teeth in the larger gear or over number of teeth in the driving gear which is the smaller gear. As you can see, they told us that the driven gear it has 30 teeth, so we're going to put 30 here. Or over the driving gear it has what, 10 teeth. You're going to put 10 here and you're going to obtain 3 as our velocity ratio. Next question says, determine the efficiency of the system if its mechanical advantage MA is 2. So, can a mechanical advantage is 2 to check the efficiency? Remember, I said efficiency, it is the measure of how well a machine works. Sagatelicity efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage over velocity. Mechanical advantage 2 over tattoo pure 2 over the velocity ratio 3 times 100. Then we are going to obtain 66.7% correct to 3 significant figures. Then other questions, Zandrungo Garanchukudza, given 2 reasons why the efficiency of a machine is always less than 100, Takudza, it's because of friction and also mass of the weight of the machine. Then still 2 ways in which the efficiency of a machine can be improved. Tikatoko nakushansa lubrication, use of ball bearings, and also build my machines using my lighter materials. And then among my examples of my machines, apart from gears, dynamo levers, pulleys, incline plane, wheel, and axle. So I think this question, it has everything, every detail that we need. A box measuring 0.3 meters wide, 0.5 meters long, and 0.6 high, has a height, has a weight of 20 newton. The box rests on a table. Define the term weight and pressure. Weight, takati, it is the force of gravity on a body. Force of gravity on a body and pressure. Force acting per unit area. Then now the question that I want to answer, which is our focus, is this one. Which says, Hansi, calculate the pressure exerted by a box when it rests on the 0.5 meter and 0.6 meter face. You need to understand something. Pressure, it is a force over area. Saka ndotanga tachaka area. This is the area already. Ndo masaidza tapo saka length times width toana this one toana iri 0,3 meters square meters. This is the area. Posta towards oti yakaresta where exactly. Right? So we are going to say what Newton the force was already given. Saka jiti force over area. Saka force yedu tina 20 Newton takatoipiwa kudara. All over area yedu taiwana pata multiply this one times this one. Ndobatawana iri 0,3 square meters. Then ndobatazo divided tikawana 66,7 pascals. Because pressure it is measured in pascals. Right, Fig 13.1 shows a pulley system used to lift a load of 600 Newton. The efficiency of the pulley system is 75%. Please be careful. This question is not friendly. Varuku dot load yangaripo, it was what? It was 600 Newton and efficiency is 75%. Be careful. Right? So it means we don't know the effort. We only have the load here. Right, so define the term machine, a device which makes work easier to do. Right, calculate the mechanical advantage of the pulley. You all realize that mechanical advantage since efficiency, right, efficiency is equal to MA over VR. Then you wanna put you wakapiwa efficiency, which is 75%, as they said. Pamsorapo. Here they said this is the efficiency. So we're going to substitute is equal to MA, the one we are looking for. Or over velocity ratio, we can find the velocity ratio here, which is 1, 2. Just count number of pulleys. So O over 2, then to that over 1. So cross multiplication. We are going to have MA equal to this one times times 100 and it times 100 here times 100 there. So it was supposed to be 100 because to get MA, let me just erase it here, right, boss? Natoresha formula yach. Alright, so it's times 100. Okay, so I want you to follow me now. We are going to say efficiency was given as 75% equal to MA times 100% here over velocity ratio, which is 2 per calculate. Then to that over 1, we apply cross multiplication. We are going to get 100 MA R equal 2 times this one. We are going to obtain 150, if I'm not mistaken. 150, then both side by 100. Both side by 100. Right, so we're going to cancel here. So our mechanical advantage is going to be this one is 1,5. This is going to be our mechanical advantage. Mechanical advantage. Now on other questions on calculations, and a pot with water is placed on an electric stove and the water is heated until it boils. All right, the electric stove is marked 2000 watts. Define the terms electrical power and electrical energy. When you're talking about electrical power, we are talking about the rate of electrical power conversion, the speed of electrical power conversion, the rate of electrical power conversion. That's what you call electrical power. And electrical energy is the work done by an electrical appliance. The work done by an electrical appliance. The water in the pot, it boils after 8 minutes. Calculate the energy supplied by the electric stove. What you need to understand, guys, is that energy is equal to power times time in seconds. You get it? Saka, our power was given as 2,000. Was given as 2,000 watts times the time already it is given in minutes. So we're going to multiply by 60 here to get it in seconds, which is going to be 480 seconds. So if we multiply, we are going to obtain 960,000 joules. J joules. Next question that we want to work on. It says a 2 amp electric heater was connected to a 110 volt supply for 1 hour. It's a 2 amp electric heater. Ya connect to a 110 volts supply for 1 hour. Calculate the cost of running the electric heater. So check tanga gaticha ke power. Gaticha ke power. Because isu stofalo zati cost yedu anditi. Cost it is the units used times the unit per kilowatt. Okay. So we are going to get what here. I think there is information that is missing. Okay. Right, we're going to first find the power. Power it is equal to voltage times chi times the current. Voltage is this one, 110, and our current is this one because it is in amperes, it is measured in amperes. And voltage by definition, it is the cell's ability to transfer energy. And another name for voltage is potential difference, PD. And it got right from there. 2A, this is current. Right, the rate of flow of charge carrier such as electrons do in on the current. Do in the power charge voltage times current to multiply 220 watts. Then we convert watts. We convert watts kumaende sa kuma kilowatts, because kilo it means 1,000, we're going to divide by 1,000 so that this one it will go to kilowatts per hour times 1 hour. So again, the 0.22 kilowatt per hour, right? Then cost of electricity, you are going to say 0.22 kilowatt per hour times the 50 cents, then you are going to get what cost the cost of running the electric heater for 1 hour. It was going to be 11 cents. That's why I'm saying pane information yanga iri missing there, because 50 cents yanga ifana kunge yaka include. Then the question that we have here, it says Fig 5.1 shows an electric circuit with three resistors, R1 which is 2 ohms and R2 which is 2 ohms and R3 which is 6 ohms. All right. State the in which R1 is connected with in relation to R2 and R3. They are connected in a parallel, in a sense you could, this one they will never meet. So it's parallel. Right, calculate the total current I in the circuit. So to one total current, tinofana kutanga tachaka inonzi total resistance. Dozo zvinofana kunzi tanga tachaka inonzi total resistance. Because kati chaka current takapowa resistance, current inenge iri kuti voltage over chi over resistance. Saka voltage inoratidza kuti iripo pa battery panapa, which is 12 volts. Anditika, saka unenge wakuchiita se wakuti eda total resistance chi? Yes. Saka tine resistance iri panapa iri connected in series. Yaimbo tinezai tinongo eda R1 plus R2 plus R3. Then to add that no one R2 it's 8 to an 8 ohms. Then kuno already tagarat 2 ohms. Right. This one my resistor I 2 alguza sa neiri kumusoro dzaka connectwa in parallel tava tichifanira ku apply ruzivo rwekutsvaka resistor in parallel patinenge tichiti isusu product over sum patiri kuti product over sum tiri kuti kudiko nai vedwe patiri kuti product over sum product over sum tiri kuti iri panapa which is 2 ohms times zvatawana apa zvese which is 8 ohms all over this is product generator then sum ku add zvandawana apa 2 ohms plus zvandawana kuno kwese kuzvazo which is 8 ohms then if we multiply again to obtain 16 all over 10 and it got this one turn 1.6 ohms this is the total resistance of this whole thing but at certain choka current ka but that current is kana wakapewa resistance is equal to voltage current is equal to voltage over resistance saka voltage it was 12 over resistance itawana iri 1.6 if I'm not mistaken so if you divide again to obtain 7.5 amps so we are done with this one let me show you more information about calculation of resistance in parallel and in series resistance how to find total greetings class welcome to Mr. Marashanye online lessons what we are going to do today is to work on what we call resistance so on these questions I am going to teach you how to actually find total resistance how to find total resistance how to find total resistance okay so the questions that we are having here it says determine this is the question that we are having determine the total resistances in the following and part A it says two resistors in a series of resistance 3 ohms and 4 ohms so what you need to know is that the total resistance in series like this the total resistance in series like this you add which means the total resistance in series you use this formula which is r1 plus r2 plus r3 which means the resistors that are connected in series you have to add them for you to get the total resistance So in this case you are going to say 3 ohms plus 4 ohms then you are going to get your total resistance as 7 ohms is your final answer moving on to the next question which is this one are two resistors in parallel how are you going to calculate two resistors in parallel so what you need to do here is to use this formula that I'm going to give you here so you are going to say for you to get the resistors in parallel use this formula product over sum by saying product over sum I am saying you are going to multiply this part times this part here which means you are going to say r1 times r2 all over r1 plus r2 okay so what are you going to get you are going to take this one as your r1 which means you're going to say 3 times your r2 here 4 all over 3 plus 4 and you're going to get 12 over 7 what is going to be your final answer it will be 1.7 ohms okay this is your total resistance And the last part that we are going to work on is the combination of resistors in parallel and in series, right? So what are you going to do here for you to get the total resistance here? You are going to get this one first, then over plus this part, which means you are going to say product of this one over its sum plus this one, okay? Because this one tongo tora sekuti it's R1. But as we add and add this one but this one is in parallel you have to do it according to the rule in parallel so you're going to say 2 times 3 all over 2 plus 3 Then zvaona this is connection in parallel. What plus this part here, which is the connection in series, what plus 4. So you are going to get 6 over 5 plus 4. And if you do your, you are going to see that you're going to obtain 5,2. If I am not mistaken, ohms. This is going to be your final answer. I hope, guys, you are assisted when it comes to calculating total resistance in parallel and in series. Please, after watching this video, don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Meet you in the next video where we are going to talk about... Right, hello guys, how are you doing? Welcome to Mr. Marashanye online lessons. Right, the main reason why I prepared this video is that I actually want you to understand what you call chemical calculations, or the calculations in chemistry. So we are going to start in a topic in on iyo ye meta. We are going to start in a topic ye meta. So it's important before we move any further for you to understand what we call matter. What is matter? Matter can be best described as anything that has mass, and volume. That is mass and volume. Okay, or matter can be defined as anything that occupy space. Anything that occupies space, chinu chese, chine mass and volume, is called matter. Chinu chese, chino kwanisa ku occupy space, chino piwa zeze kare zita, rokuti matter. Purpose of this video is to teach you chemistry calculations. But there is no way onganzwisisa chemical calculations usingazive topic inonzi matter, because ndiko kwazvinotangira. Okay? So after that, unofana kuziya kuti matter, it can be found in states. We have about 3 states of matter. Ma 3 states of matter anoti kudi. Number 1, tine inonzi solid. Kureva kuti anything that occupies space chogona kuwanika in solid state, kureva muzvinhu zvinobatika. Ndo first state. Second one, chinogona kuwanikwa in liquid state. Kurakuti anything that has mass and volume can be found in liquid. And the third one is gaseous. Kurakuti anything again that has mass and volume, or anything that occupies space, chinogona kuwanika in gaseous state. Saka pane anonzi ma changes in the states of matter are very important. Aunofanirwa kuziva. Okay, so the change of matter from solid to liquid, from solid to liquid, change of state inons iyo melting. This is called melting. Zvakafanana ne freeze it, raka freeze. Rikangirabva mukufreeze, makaoma oma, kuskara liquid, zvakaita mvura mvura, tinoti rameuta. That process is called melting. Then chinhu chakaita mvura mvura kwaona chazova gas, like zvinoita water from liquid water into steam. process iyoyo inonzi evaporation. Then kudzoka kwe gaseous state ichienda ku liquid. Kudzoka kwe gaseous state kuchienda ku liquid. Kuti kudzoka kwezvinhu zvakaita mhepo chita liquid. Iyo ndo inonzi condensation. Unozvinzwisisa kana uchinyaso kunzwisisa nyaya ye formation of clouds nekuzonaya kunoita mvura. Kuti chinomuva i water vapor ichienda in the atmosphere yosvika pa dew point, yasvika pa dew point, then that air inenge iri saturated, it is going to be cooled. Yakuliwa ifoma maclouds, maclouds ayaonaya mvura, ndo inonzi condensation. Then kudzoka kwe liquid here to solid. This is freezing. Ndo patati chiti ma freeze it edu aka freezer. This is what? Freezing. Pati kuchinja kwe estate in solid direct ichienda ku gas. Ine zita rayo. This is called sublimation. Sublimation. This process it happens mostly in ma crystals. Ma crystals ndo anokutaka hitwa anongo bvari ku solid oto tanga ku evaporate atova mhepo. Andetika. Ndo three states of matter. Wadziziva idzi. Uchibva ipapo unofana kuziva iyo inonzi atom. Chii chinobonzi atom? Ziva definition first. Is the smallest particle of matter. Saka chinonzi atom, matter chinu, chino occupy space. But the smallest particle ye chinu, chino occupy space. Do inonzi atom. Atom is the smallest particle of matter. Matter being anything that is mass and volume. But the smallest particle found in that anything that is mass and volume and in that anything that occupies space is called an atom. That atom in anonzi ma subatomic particles. Subatomic particles. What are subatomic particles? These are particles combined together to form atom. Hatigoni kutaura zveatom tisingataura anonzi ma subatomic particles anova akagadzira atom yacho. So subatomic particles can be best defined as those particles that actually make up matter, that make up atoms. So my subatomic particles, I'm going to write them down, their charge, and also mass number. So I'm going to show you, I'm going to draw a table here. So this is the table that I'm going to use. I'm going to list subatomic particles here. Topa charge yacho. Totaura zvinowanika papi, the position. Totaura mass yacho. Okay. So number one subatomic particle, we have proton. Proton inowanika pai, inowanika in the nucleus. In the nucleus of an atom. Okay, so subatomic particle yekutanga inonzi proton. Inowanika pai in the nucleus of an atom. Then charge yacho yakamira sei, it's plus one. This is the charge. Ko mass yacho I one. Number two subatomic particle yatina, it's electron. Electron in a charge of what? In a charge of minus one. Inowanika papi, inowanika muna anonzi ma electron shells. Electron shells. Kana kuti anogona kunzi ma atomic shells. Kana kuti anogona kunzi ma energy shells. Kana kuti ma orbitals. chinyongo vaone kuti doda kudedza sei. Then mass ye electron it's 1 over 1840 which is 1840. Okay? Then the last subatomic particle yatinayo inonzi iyo neutron. Right? Neutron it have a zero charge. Then also it is found in the nucleus. Right? Then the mass is actually 1. That's the mass there. Okay? So this is it. Unofana zati anonzi ma subatomic particles ndapi. Tinongorine 3. Tine proton. We have electron. We have neutron. You must also know the charge of each and every subatomic particle. The charge for proton, plus 1. The charge for electron, minus 1. The charge for neutron, 0. Where do we find proton per atom? We find it in the nucleus. Where do we find electron? In the electron shells. Where do we find neutrons? In the nucleus. You get the sense? So right this minute after this, unofana kuzoziva the structure of an atom. Apatataura masubatomic particles, ne proton, electron, and neutron. What about the structure? Yakambo mira se atom. Structure of an atom. Yakambo mira se atom. Right. Structure yacho yakamira yakadai. This is the structure. Panapa aya akaita ma rings aya. Ndo anonzi ma electron shells. Why achinzi ma electron shells? Because ndo munogara ma electrons. Because that's where you can find electrons. This is the location for electrons. So my electrons are not one gari muno. My electrons are. Nima negative charge. Don't forget. To my electrons are negative what? Charge. Promona my electrons are. Hey. Which mirror chart to me church. Then munum katum bezum. Do munonzi nucleus. Munucleus. Do matati munoanika ma protons. Do munoanika ma neutrons. Kuruwa di muno wanika ma protons. But ma protons tuma ziwa se. Ndikadai so. Ndikadai. Ma protons tuma ziwa ni kita positive charge. Positive charge. Then I asina and asia I R2. Do ma neutrons. Boza hane zero charge. Sakandika zo. Tendika I andakadai. Ndaku virajia ma protons. Nekudakwe kuti ndio ane positive charge. Then I. Ataisa ma shows I. Tatanons machia. Ma electrons. Ma electrons. Do anoiswa muma electron shells. Do chimiro che atom. Do structure of an atom. You get the sense? Okay. Then after this, wakuchifana kuziya manje atinoti ma calculations. So before we go any further, I want to show you what you call the periodic table and interpret it. Right? Here is the periodic table. About to warn us something. Tine yatinoti isusu. Alright. Periodic table ine ma atoms, ese ma atoms. Aripapa. But I want to show you something. Uchichaka any periodic table inofanirwa kunge ine key. Here, the key is this one. This is the key. Waona key iri kukudza zvese mamirira zvakaita mukato. Saka iri kutaura kuti kumusoro kuno pekutanga apa. Panenge pane inonzi element name. kureva name of the atom. For example, the name of this one is what? Potassium. Pazasi pe element name. Panenge pane inonzi atomic number. Chinonzi atomic number chi? Tirikubvira number of protons. Kuro ndo number ema protons. Kuro ati potassium ema protons mangani? 19. Potassium ema protons mangani? 19. Atomic number. Ndo number of protons. Atomic number is the number of protons. Right? From the atomic number or number of protons, I am going to see the element symbol or the atomic symbol of the atom. Atom in on the potassium. Symbol yayo ndiani? Decay. Symbol yayo ndiani? Decay. Then peku pedzisira panapa uchi round to the nearest whole number. Panike pane inonzi iyo mass number. Yavaka relative atomic mass. Inonzi mass chi? Mass number. Ziva izi kutu. Alright. Peru tutembe ndikaona yakadai. Iri kundu tuwati. Peku tanga pandopa ne element name. Panotera. Number of protons kwa atomic number. Element symbol. Ne mass number kuku pedzisira. You see? So I want to show you something. Let's go here. Right. The name of the atom here is what? Hydrogen. What is the atomic number or number of protons?
One.
It's one here. Okay. What is the element symbol for hydrogen? H. What is the mass number for hydrogen? It's one. That is round of the nearest one number. So it's one. Let's go here. The name lithium. Name of the atom. Atomic number. Element symbol. Li. Then mass number is what? It's seven. Ushtodaruchwen. Let's see. Panotera, we have sodium. Sodium do name of the atom. Sodium inema protons mangani. 11. Element symbol yacho chi? Na. Ko mass number?
23.
Ko magnesium? Atom inonza magnesium? Ine mass number chi?
12.
Mass number? Mass number?
24.
Element symbol?
Mg.
Then atomic number?
12.
Let's go. Calcium here. Mass number?
Mass number is 40.
40 element symbol?
Ca.
Name of the atom?
Calcium.
Atomic number?
20.
20. Do my interpreter and periodic table. Do not need to know somewhere else. Right, tinea tinoti nuclide notation. Nuclide notation. Sorry, I didn't have a periodic table so that I can show you. This is the periodic table. I want to draw nuclide notation for calcium here. You see? So, in the notanga, there's an element symbol C. A. You get the sense? Then pa corner pana, there is a mass number. Mass number is calcium.
Calcium 40.
Don't you have 40 here? Then pana pasa sapa, there is a proton number. Ichi?
20.
20. Don't you have 20. That drawer in on the nuclide notation. Nuclide notation in a representation, a putty, decati element symbol, for example, X and it. Pana. Parukinda mass number. Pana. Parukinda proton G. Proton number. inenge richi element simbu. Element what? Simbu. Zero batika. Ndikada ku draw futi nuclide notation for, let me say, for let me just choose anything. Vanadium here. I will say V. Then kumsoro ndoisa chi?
Atom number.
Mass number, which is an
51.
You know 51 here. Then kuzasindaisa proton number, which is what?
23.
Because this is vanadium. Done. That draw another nuclide. So that's it. I want to show you again something. Here is the structure of an atom that I was talking about. As you can see, my electron shells, your nucleus, inema protons, inema neutrons, my protons are inema positive, my neutrons are sina. Then my electrons are my shells, as you can see. Do you have that draw up? Right. Tuinda, tuda kuti tichake something here. This is nuclide notation. Okay, it will talk about panic panic on the nucleon number. Nucleon number and no mass number. Why it's in the nucleon number? That would just sanangura now. Kuno kundo panic panic proton number. Iri element G symbol. Those are never sanangura. Right, tine atom in on the carbon. Yakatu nyorwa in nuclear notation, as you can see. Ish. Nuclear. So can meaning carbon is 12 nucleons. Which means mass number carbon is 12. Of which 6 are protons. 6. Kwadati kwe sabu kwenda proton number kusasi. 6. Right? So can C is the chemical element for carbon. Kurad carbon. Its chemical element is what? Just a C. You see? Ziva is also. Right. Question ya tana ipana paya kuti define relative mass. Chi chinonzi relative mass.
Or mass number.
Tiri kubvira total number of protons and neutrons in a nucleus. Kuna kuti mu nucleus matati murukwani kwa ma protons, murukwani kwa ma neutrons. The total number of protons and neutrons, do you know the mass number? Kura kuti yes, atati chiti I ndazonyora mass number yangu iri panapa ishi yatuti 12 yawani katati chi proton plus neutron. Somebody guess. Kura kuti mass e 12 ndaiwana ndati ma protons plus g ma neutrons. Anoendi chiri kumeka sense here kuti chiri chese here ipapo. Bozi kana mass number iri total number of ma protons plus neutrons. This is the formula here. Kuyoka zopiwa paka dions chaka number of neutrons. Unungo wao zaka kuti indakadza kuti mass iri equal to proton plus neutron. Ndizoka. Mass andine here.
Tina.
Dakuti 12. Ari equal to proton
6.
Plus n. Wakutotora yenda kwi. Yeti vachita 12 minus what? 6 is equal to what? N. So wano ngeta kumensi ya kuti ikaenda kwi. The other side nusika ishita negative. 12 minus 6 to wana chi? 6. Kwa wadu manutrons alipapa banga? E6. Dosa kandanyi nyo kudzidzisa inonzi nuclide notation. Shiru kupinda anditi? Duo panda chita wala panditi chiti atomic number. Duo proton number. I don't know how to define proton number or atomic number. No number of protons in the nucleus of an atom. Then the atomic number can have proton G number. Then the atomic number can have proton G number. Let's continue. Kuita to Pachagumi ready for today. Mangwana Titakurama calculations. Why? Right. Paragunzi isotopes. Chi chinonzi isotope. Paragunzi are atoms of the same element with same atomic or proton number, but different mass number. Glory be to God. It's same type of an atom. No one got carbon, carbon, carbon. Should be. Those in your life. Tine carbon 12, carbon 13, and carbon 14. Second, got carbon element symbol in nuclear. The carbon 12. Proton number carbon I change 6. Twenty carbon 13. Then you have 13 mass number. Proton I change 6. Carbon 14. Proton number 6. Duda kuti ndi define in on the isotope using this example. So an isotope can be best described as the same type of an atom. Kana kuti ma atoms of the same type. Let me say that these are atoms of the same type. Carbon, 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 same type again. With the same proton number 6, 6, 6, but different mass number 12, 13, 14. Then it's isotope. So change the isotopes. Is isotope? Isotopes. Those are atoms of the same type, kind, with the same proton number, but different what? Mass number. Saka is same type of an atom, carbon, 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 with the same proton number 6, 6, 6, but different mass number. 12 here, 13 here,
14.
Should make a sense? So, tinotone ma isotope akawandisa. Tine inonzi chlorine isotope. Kune inonzi chlorine 35, kwete inonzi chlorine what? 37.
Okay.
Urukuona kuti is same type chlorine, chlorine. Same number of protons 17, 17. But different mass number
35 and
37. Again, tine oxygen isotopes. Kune oxygen 16, kweta oxygen 18. Again, tine same type of an atom, oxygen, oxygen. With the same proton number 8, 8. But different mass number 16 here, 18 here. Right? Dopa tuda kuti tigumire nasi apa. Patunufana kakudziza kuti ndinomboka kuleta say number of neutrons. Naboku uzagataka mira patati pa nuclear di ui pa. Tuda kuona kuti chlorine ish. Ine ma neutrons manga. Dizo. Saka iwezi ya kuti kana mass number. Iri equal to proton plus neutron. Ko neutron ichi, neutron, nuko yemeka subject, is equal to mass minus proton. Chet, kanongo substitute as ya zongo zobuda shiga futi. Saka kuti ndiwane number of neutrons hii, denote mass which is 35, minus proton which is
17.
Nuba ndawana number of what? Of neutrons. You get the sense? Ndikada kuchaka. Dinenda kudichi? Neutron is equal to mass minus proton. Saka mass yangu ndiani? 37 minus 17. Ndowana neutron yangu. Saka ndikati 35 minus 17. Ndinowana erichi? Is it 18 or so? 35, 17 up. Yeta 8. It's 18. And it? Ko 37 minus 17. Do you want it 20?
No.
It must be 20 there. Ko 7 minus 2 is 0. It's 20. Done. Ko kanandika dao kuchaka mass number ipapa ine si neutron number ndio wana si
mass
which is that
mass which is
16 minus
proton number which is 8
tuanani neutron
8
neutrons tuenda mantera
Tadiji neutron is equals to mass
minus proton number
which is 18
18
minus 8
tuanani
8
tuanani 18 minus 8
210
au kudaka So we are going to continue now talking about concentration. You know, concentration by definition, it is the ratio of moles of a solute to the ratio to the volume of a solution. And this is the formula. They are saying for us to get concentration, we must say number of moles all over volume in decimeter cubed. This is the formula. In decimeter cubed. Right? Then my units a concentration, it can be measured in mole per decimeter cubed or in gram per decimeter cubed. Here is a good example that we have. Right? They are saying, find the number of moles of sodium hydroxide in 25 cubic centimeters of solution of concentration 0.1. But before we answer this one, let us start by this one. Do not check a question and go for the direct concentration. So that tozo tangaku answer. Right, Saka, we have this question here. And it says, what is the concentration of a solution prepared by dissolving 2 gram of calcium chloride in 250 mils of water? So you need to understand one thing. Concentration always is equal to number of moles or over volume in decimeter cubed. So the volume we are given is not in decimeter cubed here. So we must convert this volume yoyenda kuma decimeter cubed. If you are given the volume in mils, you convert this one kuenda ku decimeter cubed by just dividing this one by 1000. So this is it. 250 mils is equal to 0.250 decimeter cubed. Why wanna say they just divide this one by what? 1000. And they obtained this one. This is the volume that we are going to use. We only use volume in decimeter cubed for us to get the concentration. Right? From there, you must also find the number of moles. How do you find number of moles? You say the given mass on the question or over the formula mass. Correct? You must find the formula mass for calcium chloride. And the formula mass for calcium chloride, most of the time, when you go to Cooper, it's only. Can I pass in the one Cooper formula so that you can calculate? Right? So, the formula mass for calcium chloride is 111. So, that is the given mass, which is 2 gram over the molar mass of calcium chloride, which is 111. Then, it's a pando number of what? Number of moles. After having volume in decimeter cubed and number of moles, we can now find concentration. We are going to say number of moles, which is 0.18 here, or over volume in decimeter cubed, which is 0.250. Then you are going to obtain concentration, which is 0.072 more per decimeter cubed. How do I get number of moles? Dizoga. Unogona kunzi iwewe, for example. I'm just giving you an example. So this is the formula. So I was telling you. Right. Unogona kunzi iwewe 2 gram of, let me give example, carbon dioxide. Right? So I am saying number of moles in this case, moles is equal, the given mass is what? 2 grams. All over mass of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide by formula is CO2. Ndo patuno chaka inonzi relative molecular mass. Ye papa, ndo ya tukuti molar mass yu. Saka tita kuti mass number ye carbon E12 times, right, which is 12 times the number of carbon atoms ziripanapa is just 1. Tova 30 plus. Mass number of oxygen is 16 from the periodic table times my number of oxygen atom 2. So what it means is that we are going to obtain 12 times 1, we're going to have 12 plus 32, then we're going to have 44 as our answer. This is molecular mass of what? Carbon dioxide. Nope, yet no say sapana. For us to get how many moles are there in 2 grams of carbon dioxide? Then to actually divide up by 2 to 1 by 2 to 1 over 22. Saka always is your concentration. Unofana zoti concentration yako, it's number of moles or over volume in this meter cube. If you are given number, or if you are not given number of moles, tanga wa chaka. Can also not pure foot volume in decimeter cube to convert whatever that is given to decimeter cube. You get it? So let's go to that question. That question is it's a bit tricky, a bit charm. So I found go to very good to already you're given. You're given, right? This is an example. So what mass of sodium carbonate is needed to prepare blah 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 moles per blah 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 in water? You see? So they are saying concentration is equal to this one, mass, but the concentration was but they are saying concentration number of moles over volume in decimeter cube. But convert this one over like the bio per concentration is 0.2 mole per liter. You see? So but the number of moles, you go with a cross multiplication to put a panupana x over 1 year with a cross multiplication. If you're not x are equal to this one times this one, then you get 0.05. Find the mass divide, find the mass dissolved using the formula. Can I go to mass manager? Number of moles is equal to mass over g formula mass. Second number of moles, unazi oguda. That's a copy one. A papa one's a more per decimeter. More per. Second one, I'm going to this one. Number of moles point that I want to say, what we store 0.05 ways up. What is got mass given mass over 0.106, which is a cross multiplication. Not 5 grams, Sakashan. It's 5 grams, 5.3 grams. Saka now don't change my questions. I am so these questions that we have it would manage find the number of moles of sodium hydroxide in 25 cubic centimeters of solution of concentration. Concentration is here, volume is here. Question would you find the number of what? Number of moles is over. Right, what they are trying to say here is right, find the number of moles of sodium hydroxide in 25 cubic centimeters of solution of concentration 0.1 mole per decimeter cubed. So you want the chakachi number of what? Number of moles. What they are saying is if concentration is equal to number of moles over volume. Sakura is really easy to do a number of unogo make a M the subject. Sakura so, got over one. Crowd will also e come up crowd number of moles. Those one that concentration times volume. No formula. Right? So the number concentration was already given 0.1 mole per decimeter cubic. That was the concentration, 0.1 times volume 1 cubic centimeter is equal to 1 decimeter cubed. Wabata conversion. What does it? 1 cubic centimeter.
1
decimeter cubed. Rangu fanana. That's why wangu wana kuti apa isusu tikadua kuda etita mtungurote apa tatuwa nema cube, nema decimeter cubed edu. Kuna 25 cubic centimeters and 25 decimeters cubed. That's why I'm applying this one.
Okay.
Saka yata wana ndo number of what? Of moles. Awana kupunza concentration. Wala kupa concentration. Wala kupa volume. Wala kutu chaka number of moles.
Just the same. Wala kupiwa. Chaka like. Wala kutu chaka mass.
That's it. Then tenda pano tell. And find the volume of solution of concentration 2 mole per decimeter cubed that contains 0.005 moles of hydrochloric acid. You get it? Saka istongo mega vuti V the subject. Saka volume is equal to concentration over mass. Over number of moles, sorry. M is number of moles. And did it? Saka teta kutichi concentration at a pure it's 2 over. Mamoza atapiwa 0.005. Auto divide kaka. I don't know. Apango wakiti ya. Auto divide boom, boom. Ameno kutuwewa na hili chi ide. Volume is equal. Let me try to use calculator. Okay, calculator yangu ya sikuita. Saka ndichasha nze mphone. Two divide by 0.005. Two divide by 0.005. It's 400. It's 400 cubic centimeters. Kana kutiba. Decimeter G. Decimeter cube. But follow me didn't follow me in decimeter. You better write this one. Now working on acids, bases, and salts. I just want to summarize this. Right. Acid is a proton donor by definition. Proton what? Donor. Basare ngo dunte ma protons.
Okay.
Why list base? You know, accept my protons.
Okay. You know, receive.
Accept proton. Saka acid is a proton donor. Base is a proton is a proton acceptor.
Okay.
That's it. Is a proton acceptor. The acid proton donor, then base proton acceptor. Then my salts, we need to talk about them. Right, this is the behavior of acids per and my bases per anions P. pH scale. And it right. What is a pH scale? In a scale, you know, measure if the solution is a base or an alkaline or an acid. In a measure, what is solution at in a acid ere, e base ere, chi is it neutral? Saka in the pH, it ranges from 1 to 7, 1 to 14. Do range, as you can see, vapanapa. That is a pH scale. But to corner solution, yes, we can range up and a 7 up. Color in Obuda Ipap in a gay green. Correct is a good E in the E neutral. Open up in the one up in water. This one. But any solution in a range above 7 and my alkalis.
Alkaline.
And it got. Then in a range below 7, my acids S. My acids.
Hello.
Below 7, my acids. Right. Saka, my solution inongo range below 7. Below 7, the acid. Above 7, ma basis kana ma alkaline ndi but manje unofazo nzoti inozo range kubva pa 1 up 2 3 ndo ma strong acids akaita sana sulfuric acid nitric acid hydrochloric acid anditika then ano range wa pa 4 5 6 ma weak acids ndo panopinda vana acetic acid vana lactic acid anditika then wo ma alkaline ano range wa kubva pa 8 up 9 10 up ma weak alkaline but ano range wa pa 11 12 13 14 ma strong alkaline saka unofana kuziyawo ma color futhi kuti solution ikaiswa pa universal indicator kana kuti pa pH scale ikabudisa orange is it a strong acid yes ikabudisa red is a strong acid saka kureva kuti ma acids ese anotena universal indicator red no one of the characteristics ye ma acids number 1 character tichi ine pH below chi 7 number 2 tikati pa universal indicator inotochinja kuendesa ku red but ma bases anochinja kuendesa ku blue wapo ona another difference it ranges from 0 to 14 it shows how acidic or alkaline a solution is acids have pH values less than 7 while alkaline have pH values greater than 7 if a substance has a pH of 7 it is neutral e.g. pure water anditika then my indicators litmus paper is an example of an indicator and the universal indicator being most important it is the mixture of dyes that change color gradually over the range right pa universal indicator litmus paper ikatena from red to blue ikuratidza kuti ichi ibase anditika uzotobva kutaurazvo but universal indicator ikatenawo from blue ikaenda ku red inenge iri chi inenge iri acid bonzo zvatabva kutaura kuti red ma acids blue ma bases kana ma alkaline anditika then tenda pa ma strong acids na ma strong is not really important pada pandokuda pa ma reactions right reaction yema acids nema metal kuti any acid ikangoreacta ne metal any acid ikareacta ne metal panobuda salt ne gas rinonzi hydrogen it depend manje pa salt inobuda kana iri sulfuric acid inobudisa salt inonzi sulfate saka inenge ichinzi metal sulfate something saka tikati isusu magnesium plus sulfuric acid tinowana magnesium sulfate plus hydrogen gas always hydrogen gas is produced when an acid react to the metal you get it eh
yeah.
Right then it experiment I don't know kuti onyaso show era pana ma apparatus acho avakaratidza let's go to the differences between ma acids nema bases saka ma acids tataura isusu kuti akasiyana siyana now you can see kuti ese anonzi ma bases ma metal oxides or hydroxides saka tikati magnesium hydroxide i metal ndikati magnesium oxide i metal i base sorry ma bases these are metal oxides kurati i metal yakabatana ne oxygen saka aya ndo ma difference between ma acids ne ma bases remember yakutanga tati ma acids are proton donor aya ma proton acceptor another difference is that acid is a sour taste and the adverse is never test it ma bases is a slippery few and test bitter never test it again then ma acids anotena blue litmus paper kuenda kuchi red tabos taona kumusoro kuya then ma bases anotena red litmus kuenda kuchi blue ma acids they are corrosive zvinoreva kuti anodya anything chaagumana nacho anything chagumana nacho, anything. Ma acids, they are corrosive. Why? Nekuti they eat away materials that come in contact with it. But ma bases, some bases are caustic, e.g. potassium hydroxide. They are not as corrosive as what? As ma acids. Then ma acids, ese, they react with the base to form salt and water. A reaction inonzi iyo neutralization. Neutralization, they are kati e reaction between acid and base to form salt and water only. Saka kunoko on the other end, base, it reacts with base, it reacts with acid. Apart from not with the acid, but this is a base. No, reaction, acid to form salt and water only. Right?